Hello everyone. In previous sessions, we discussed about the electrical drives. That means different concepts included in types of drives and speed control methods and starting and braking of DC and AC motors. Okay. In today's session, we are going to solve different previous questions regarding electrical drives. Let's start the session. Okay, the first question is what they are asking. The load torque versus speed characteristics of a industrial load is given below. The motor suitable for this load is. Okay, whatever the characteristics is given, we are going to write the equation here. From the given characteristics, we are going to write the equations. And also, at the time of starting, torque is high. At the rate of starting, torque is high. So, from the given characteristics, we can able to derive these two conditions. Okay, we can able to derive these two conditions. So, by observing these two, we can say for this, if it is a DC motor, we are going to prefer DC series motor. If you want to use it for AC motor, we are going for slip ring induction motor. Let's see the options what they given: DC shunt motor, 3-phase induction motor, DC series motor and capacitor motor. But the most preferred one for this high starting torque is DC series motor. We need to give option DC series motor. If DC series motor is not there in option and they are mentioning the slip ring induction motor as an option, then we need to choose the slip ring induction motor. Coming to next question. The question is about the armature resistance and brush voltage drop of 120 volts DC shunt motor are 0.2 ohms and 2 volts respectively. The current at the instant of starting equals to. Okay, whenever you are solving questions on electrical machines, first we need to note down the what is the given data. Let's note down the given data. If you note down, the terminal voltage VT is equal to 120 volts and armature resistance RA is equal to 0.2 ohms and brush drop. They are given brush drop as 2 volts. Okay, they are given brush drop as 2 volts. And what they are asking, current at the rate instant of starting. So they are asking starting current. Okay, starting current they are asking. So we know that at the time of starting EB is equal to 0. We know that at the time of starting EB is equal to 0. So if you write the KVL equation for a motor, what we will get? VT is equal to EB plus IARA and brush drop. Okay, normally brush drop is will be neglected, but whenever they mention in the question brush drop, we need to include in our equation. Okay, so from this, what at the time of starting EB is going to be 0, then the equation can be, from this equation, the current IA at the time of starting can be written as VT minus brush drop by RA. Okay, VT minus brush drop by RA. So VT is 120 volts and brush drop is 2 volts. Then RA is, they given, RA is 0.2 ohms. After simplification, we will get current at the time of starting is equal to 590 amperes. Okay, after simplification, we will get armature current at the time of starting will be 590 amperes. The option is A. Is it clear? Coming to next question, the starting current and torque of a 3-phase induction motor are 30 amps and 300 newton meters. What are the corresponding values with the star delta starter? Okay, they given the DOL starter details. That means starting current, let's take it as short circuit current is 30 amps and torque is 300 newton meters, and they are asking with respect to star delta. So by seeing options itself, we can write. Okay, we know that in star delta, in star delta, this is DOL starter. In star delta starter, what is going to happen? 1 by 3 times of DOL starter. Okay, it is current is going to be reduced by 1 by 3 times. So then the option will be 10 amps. Okay, so if you see the options, you can directly choose the first option A. Next one is selection of electric motor for any application depends on. Okay, so for any application, what are the parameters we need to see? First, the way they given electrical characteristics. Electrical characteristics are nothing but voltage and current, load current. You can say it as load current. Load current. Okay, these are the characteristics for the electrical characteristics for the given load. We need to see. Next one is mechanical characteristics. That means torque and speed. Torque and speed. At the time of starting, whether it is a high start motor or normal start, constant start motor, and if it required constant speed or variable speed, based on that we need to choose. And third is size and rating of the motor. Okay, size and rating of the motor. It depends on the load, the rating of the motor may change. Okay, and depends on the space. The space means if you are having very less space and we need to accommodate the drive, means for less space you are going for the AC motors compared to DC motors. Already we discussed. Okay, this means what you are going to see, HP value, horsepower value, and size of the requirement. So next is cost. Okay, whether the load is operating, whether the load we need to operate at a high cost level or low cost level. That means mostly if you see the industrial applications, the production cost should be less, as minimum as possible. So the cost also one parameter in the selection of the motor. Okay, if you see, all these are required, then only you can able to select the suitable motor for our given drive. So the option is all of this. Next is the starting torque of DC motor is independent of which of the following. Okay, what they are telling is starting torque. Okay, starting torque. At the time of starting, what is the speed? Speed equal to zero. At the time of starting, speed equal to zero. And we know torque is directly proportional to armature flux and armature current. We know the relation. Okay, from this given option will be flux and armature current. It is going to depends on both flux and as well as armature current. That's why our option will be C. C is the most appropriate answer. Next, by varying the armature circuit resistance, speed of DC motor can be varied. The motor then becomes, okay, what they are asking, they are controlling the, we know that the speed is equal to V minus IARA by pi. Okay, V minus IARA by pi. What they are asking, they are controlling the armature resistance. If you are controlling the armature resistance, then what will happen? The speed is going to be decreased. Okay, if you increase the armature resistance, the speed is going to be decreased. Okay, so that means N is going to be less than N rated. That means below rated speed you are going to operate, or below base speed you are going to operate. This type of drive we have already discussed, the adjustable speed drive loads. Okay, adjustable speed drive loads means like this, it will be there. This is the N rated, this is N rated, and this is N less than N rated and N greater than N rated. Okay, this is the base speed or rated speed you will say. So this mode is called constant torque mode or constant torque drive. This is here power is constant. So in our case, it is falling under the N less than N rated. So it is operating below rated speed. So it is going to be constant torque drive. Next question is, the plugging of DC shunt motor, the resistance is inserted in a armature circuit. Okay, we know that IB for in plugging, IB can be written as V plus EB by RA plus RB.
What is the plugging? Plugging is nothing but we are interchanging the armature terminals and we are connected to the supply. Because of that, the current will be very high. During plugging process, the current will be very high. To limit that only, we are connecting RB. Okay, to limit that only, we are connecting the RB. So, the purpose of RB is to reduce the breaking current. To reduce the breaking current. Limit the armature current. Okay, or to limit the armature current. The suitable option is C. Next, which one of the following curves represents the speed torque characteristics of a DC series motor? DC series motor. One thing we need to remember, whenever the DC series motor comes on the picture, means first thing we need to remember is high starting torque. Just remember high starting torque. For DC series motor, the first thing we need to remember is it is going to provide high starting torque. Just see the characteristics. In which characteristics we are getting high starting torque? At the starting, means at the time of starting, if you see, this is having high starting torque. This is having high starting torque. If you see the other characteristics, these are not providing the high starting torque characteristics. That's why option will be D. Is it clear? Speed control of shunt motor by the variation of field flux will provide which type of drive? Okay. So we know that N is inversely proportional to the flux. N is inversely proportional to the flux of the armature. What we are going to do, we are going to control the flux. We are going to control the flux. How we are going to control the flux? We are going to reduce the flux, thereby speed is going to be increased. That means N is greater than N rated. Okay, N is greater than N rated. We know that the variable speed load characteristics is like this. Okay, this is the rated speed and this is N is less than N rated and this is N is greater than N rated. So now in this question, the our load is falling in this region. Here it is a constant power drive. Constant power drive. Okay, since variable speed is comes under in this region, this is called constant power drive. We already explained the concept. So, it will be constant power drive. Next question. A 200 volts DC shunt motor is running at 1000 RPM and drawing a current of 10 amps in a winding resistance 2 ohms. It is braked by plugging the resistance to be connected in series with the armature to restrict the armature current to 10 amps. So, one thing we need to remember whenever the questions are coming on the machines, first we need to note down the given data. What is the given data? VT is given as 200 volts. VT is given as 200 volts and speed, running speed, that means rated speed is 1000 RPM. Current, armature current also given, IA is equal to 10 amps. Its armature winding resistance is 2 ohms, RA is equal to 2 ohms. It is braked by plugging. So, whenever the term plugging comes, means we know IB is equal to V plus EB by RA plus RB. Okay, V plus RA plus RB, what he is telling? Resistance to be inserted to limit the current to 10 amps. So, he is asking to calculate the braking resistance to make the IB is equal to 10 amps. Okay, this is the given data. Since it is a plugging process, we are going to use this formula. From the given data, if you observe, all other terms we know except EB, all other terms we know. So, for getting EB, we know that if you apply the KVL, V is equal to EB plus IARA. From this, EB is equal to V minus IARA. V is given as 200 and IA is 10 amps, RA is 2. So, 200 minus 20
that equal to 180 volts. And if you substitute this value in this IB, okay, if you substitute this value in IB, what we will get? IB is equal to IB they given. IB they given as 10 amps. So we know V is 200. V is 200 and EB is 180. VB is 180. We need to find out RB. RA, what is RA given? RA given as 2 ohms. RA given as 2 ohms and RB we need to find out. Okay. Let's assume it as a RB. Let's assume it as a RB. By simplifying this, what we will get? 20 plus 10 RB equal to 380. 20 plus 3 RB is equal to 380. Then 10 RB is equal to 360. Therefore, RB is equal to 36 ohms. Okay, then RB equal to 36 ohms. Then option is B. Okay, don't get panic whenever the problems are coming and lengthy, especially whenever the problem length is more, the solution will be very, very less. This is the simple trick in electrical machines. Just note down the given data and see the process, what process they are doing with the motor. So just remember the formulas related to that process and substitute the given data, we will get the required terms. Is it clear? Okay. Next, if the actual speed of induction motor is equal to the synchronous speed, the torque developed will be. What is telling the rotor speed NR is equal to NS? Okay, the rotor speed NR is equal to NS. Whenever the rotor speed NR equal to NS means what will happen? Okay, whenever rotor speed then slip is equal to 0. That means torque is, sorry, whenever NR equal to NS, whenever NR equal to NS, what is going to happen? NR is equal to NS. Motor at standstill. What we are going to tell? Motor at standstill. Motor at standstill. So, motor at standstill. So, it is not able to generate any torque. Okay. So, motor going to be stopped. The torque developed will be zero. Okay. Torque developed will be zero. In another way, what we will tell? The principle of induction motor mainly depends on the relative motion between the synchronous speed of the flux and speed of the rotor. If this relative motion is zero, that means if NR catches the NS, then the torque production is going to be zero. In that way also you can say, okay? So option will be zero. The starting torque of a cage rotor induction motor can be increased by using rotor halving, okay? So what they are telling is starting torque. We already know the starting torque of the equation by approximate analysis. 3 omega s into V1 square R2 dash by s into X2 dash square. This is the equation we know. Okay. So if you see, yeah, starting torque is directly proportional to R2 dash. So for high starting torque, so what they are telling, to increase the starting torque, what are the parameters of resistance and inductance? So R2 dash should be high. Okay, first condition is this one. And second condition, starting torque is inversely proportional to the 1 by x2 dash square. X2 is nothing but omega L. Okay, so starting torque is inversely proportional to the square of the L, we can write. Okay, so in order to get a high starting torque, it should be very low. So finally our answer is high resistance and low inductance. Okay, high resistance and low inductance.